Hi, Nico here, your local Missouri well man. Along with get those hose turkey calls now. With our advanced technology, our tile calls and our walnut striker along with our bottle cap make some of the best strikers there is. Got those pretty kelts. Got those purrs. Sound real pretty. And then we got those clucks. Those sound really good. And then we got our turkey call made out of walnut here along with a cherry striker bottle cap on. Kind of has a little bit more of a raspier sound to it. Well, it needs a little bit of chalk on it. Unfortunately, I don't have any with me here today. May find a spot here. Sounds a lot better outside, but that's it there. And they can be purchased for $5 a call. And thank you for watching, Missouri Wild Men. Next creature we're going after is the Goat Man. Now, he's believed to be a scientist that went to fooling around with different animals' DNA and grabbed a whole goat's DNA and put it inside itself and got changed to a goat somehow or another. So he's half man, half goat, and he has sworn to get his revenge on those who made fun of him, saying that he couldn't do it. What can you tell me, Alan?
Well, he's half goat, half man. The top part of him is goat and the bottom part's man. He has some pretty big horns out there. He has glowing red eyes.
Why are they the horns?
About half a foot.
That's some big horns for this animal.
Anyway, he has red eyes, whitish, gray dark fur, and he doesn't sound like a regular goat. It's kind of like a howlish.
So he don't go bah.
Nope. Nico?
Yeah.
Do this kind of like howlish goat thing.
Do a howlish goat thing?
Yeah, try it. Kind of like that, yeah.
Sound like
kind of sounds like that.
Sounds like he's choking on something.
Yeah.
Probably all those human parts that he has up there. Anyway, this creature's around on the edge of Missouri, and the scientist lived way back in the woods and everything, and he was just trying to make some animals and all this stuff. God, we got a lot of traffic out here.
Yeah, we sure do.
Anyway, he's out there splicing DNA and everything, trying to make new animals, and he spliced himself.
Well, that sucks for him, don't it?
He turned into a mutated goat.
If we catch him, Lawrence, what are you going to do with his horns? Are you going to keep them?
Probably mount them on my wall.
Yeah, get his head up there, too.
I will.
Get a full body mount.
That'll be, yeah, it'll be mounted. I can't wait to build this trap.
Yeah, this is going to be a pretty good little adventure we have going on here. As soon as this person gets off the dang road.
Get off the freaking road. Anyway, what type of trap are you gonna build?
Well, big enough one to hold a goat.
I bet you think that's gonna be.
Don't really be a fail. 5 foot? Tall?
No, this goat doesn't stay on both the all fours. He's
how tall is this animal?
He's about 6.5.
6.5.
Yeah, with his horns. I'm gonna have to build a 6.5 foot tall and 10 foot wide.
Yeah, he doesn't have hands. He has those little hooves.
So what you're saying is you're gonna build him like a house, so that way whenever he walks in, he's boom, caught.
Yeah.
Now remember, guys, this isn't the big bad wolf. Anyway, this goat is not a wolf or anything. It's not gonna huff and puff and blow the house down. So we need to probably get something like wood.
The base of it's gonna be metal.
So it's gonna be metal.
Then all the way up is gonna be wood.
Then we're gonna put Reed in a goat costume and have him go there and start.
Meh.
And then bring the old goat man in, let him have his way with him.
Yeah.
Yeah, good old Chris. Chris.
Good old Chris, yeah.
Good old Chris is gonna be in that goat outfit.
Yeah. Sounds like a great idea to me.
What are we gonna bait it with?
Well, we're gonna have Chris dress up as a goat.
Chris, no food or anything out there? Meat?
Okay, goats don't eat meat.
It's a half man, half goat. You never know.
We'll throw a chef salad in there.
Yeah. Good old chef salad.
So that way he has vegetables and he has his meat and he's happy.
Yep.
Well, we're about a mile and a half from this, whatever it's called nowadays.
Watch out for that goat man.
Yep, hopefully we don't run into it.
Time for Wild Man Minute.
Thomas! Been here today. Duke cannot be with us. He's on a family vacation. And our partner Nico said he had a strange encounter with some type of goat creature. Nico, why don't you tell us about it?
Well, I was sitting in my deer stand one day in October around pretty rough, best time to hunt. And I was just sitting there and I heard something right behind me. So I turned around like that and I seen something. It was kind of making like a weird noise, like a noise I never heard before. It was kind of like a mix between a doe bleat and like a grunt and a howl. Like it was really weird. And then I seen something white, and gosh dang, it was huge, about 6 foot tall, and it just ran right through. And I got a pretty good look at it too. Like it had horns that were like those mountain sheep, like that curled around.
Like goats.
Yeah, like a goat's. And he ran right through and he stopped. And then I went to pull my bow back and shoot at him. And then he ran off. I didn't see no more of him. He beat that brush. Sounded like there was a gosh darn war going on.
Well, what would you call this creature?
Well, I never seen anything like it before. But from all the research that I've been doing, it looks like to me it could be the goat man. I mean, this thing was scary looking.
Well, I think we better get after this before it gets worse.
Yep.
Yeah. I guess we'll get after it tonight, won't we?
Yep.
Alrighty.
What should we bait it with?
Probably a chef salad.
This sounds very good.
Lawrence here. Gonna make a trap. Try to catch this goat man. And this is what I'm gonna be doing. I'm gonna be making a snare trap. And what you do is get off this wire about yay long.
How long is that?
I don't know. I don't have a tape measure.
Well, how do you know how long it is? Like, don't you have special requirements that it has to reach?
Yeah, or it's gonna be a net trap.
Okay.
Look at that kid.
That thing ain't gonna come off unless it breaks.
So what's the rust wire supposed to do?
If you get the head in it, this wire is gonna go wrap around here. Like that.
Looks like you're trying to hang something.
Then when he slips down in there, it'll catch him and he ain't gonna go nowhere.
Oh, look at that.
Because it'll just get tighter.
Yeah, that's a mighty impressive trap you got there,
Chris. You got Alan over there as a cameraman, because old cowboy, he couldn't make it out here tonight. So
he's grounded, is that right?
I don't know, that's what they say. Nico, you want to tell us what we're doing out here?
Yeah, thank you for asking, Chris. Now, we've had reports of this goat man is right out here in this hollow. Now, I've seen him pretty close right up this draw here. Now, my deer stand's just right up on top of the hill up here, and we're going to do our best to catch him. Now, we've got a chef salad set up out here because the goat man, he's an omnivore. That means he eats meat and vegetation. So,
I've seen him been eating grass up there where I set up the traps because I knew he'd been there, and I've seen traps.
Yeah. Well, I guess we're going to make our way up there. Oh, and we're also going to be trading off camera people. All right, so I guess we'll get a move on.
Hey Chris, you got a light on you? You guys have a light on you?
No, not on me.
Yeah, I got a light here.
Make sure we can see you guys.
That track is. That one right there. That's a big track. I guess he was laying somewhere right in there. And
he took off that way because here's some scuff marks.
Where he took off that. Yeah, I guess he put his foot down and got in a hurry and went to run.
Let's track it, boy.
He was pretty warm, too. Yeah, because look, guys. Look at all that.
You can definitely tell he has some goat in him because goats only just about any damn thing there is.
He nubbed there a little bit.
Yep.
Where?
That's okay. And they're my thorns, too. I would hate to eat that, wouldn't you?
Yeah, that wouldn't be very appetizing to me.
No, me neither.
Now you can see where he's been rubbing up on here. Where he took that big old horn and went straight up the tree now. I don't know about you guys, I'm about 5'10 and a half. And that is about...
Six
inches taller than me. So, he must be around 6'2", 6'3". Man. His head must be down there. I'm saying his head's about there. His horns are up here. All righty. Man, he just tore the brush to pieces.
Where do you think they're bedding at here at night?
I don't know. I think he's bedding either in this holler or on this hillside. What direction is the wind out of?
I think it comes from the north.
What I think of these things, G, they bed down.
That way. Fish are good.
Maybe he has special spots where he likes to lay for different directions that the wind's out of those.
Nico, you said you did some research on him. When does he like to move around? Is
Look
it
at this.
Afternoon or is it night or what is it?
Well, hey. Mainly afternoon.
Yes.
Hmm. Yeah, he's been rubbing on that too, hasn't he?
Mm.
Let's see how fresh this is. That's about a day old.
Yeah. Probably a day or so.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh.
There's
a lot of
adventures here, guys. Yeah. Oh,
now that
actually could be a Bigfoot. Mm. You can actually see little prints there.
Mm-hmm.
See? There's 1, 2, 3. There's a good 7 there if the big feet don't have 7 feet.
Yeah, there must be some Bigfoot in this area too.
Well, you reckon them Bigfoot and them goat fighting against each other?
It wouldn't surprise me, according to Cherokee legend. The goat man and Bigfoot fight over territory sometimes.
That's a big foot.
Yeah, that's about a foot.
Yeah, about 2.
Well, guys, let's head this way.
Oh, you are? All right.
Just keep going that way. We're going to go down this way.
Okay, guys. Me are together. And Chris and Alan split up. And we're going to meet back up at the trap.
Oh.
There they are.
There they are somewhere over there.
Whoa, look at that, guys. Looks like he's been here.
Yeah, that's a
nice scrape.
Yeah, that's a pretty good scrape there.
Looks fresh.
Yeah, well, I guess we'll head back up to the trap.
I think the trap's that way, Nico. What was that? traps back up this way. We gotta find that trail. Hey, Nico, this way.
There you are, Chris. I can't find the trap. Can you guys? Hey, Nico, can you find it? Come on, Chris.
Just missed him.
Yeah, that leaf pile looks pretty messed up.
And that rock's gone too.
This thing must have a very incredible speed to get past this trap and that trigger, because any other person would have got caught.
Yeah, it would. Ow. That hurt.
You're right in that trap.
Oh, still, Lawrence, quit kicking. Here, bring your foot forward.
Hold on.
You know, Nico?
Oh, God. He's about to kick me under the belt. There, boys.
Lawrence, you out? Where'd this sound come from?
From the tree. That was standing, wasn't it?
I think it was. He must have knocked that tree over.
Hey, why? I don't think it comes from up there.
You see?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I guess he beat us this time.
Yeah. Well, if that ain't proof that the goat man's real, I don't know what is.
I don't know either, bub.
This has been Missouri Wild Men. Chris?
Chris?
Lawrence?
Nico, thank you for watching. Yep.